We try to plan for as many things as possible, but this type of training is a safe environment for some of these higher stress careers to make mistakes and learn from them. We're simulating real stress here.
We don't teach you how to do your job. Survival systems teaches you how to do your job safely. You are the expert in your job. But we are here to make sure that you understand the tools that are at your disposal and come home at the end of the day.
As an elevator mechanic or apprentice like me, the job is pretty dangerous. Working safe is definitely our number one priority.
At Survival Systems, we see a whole variety of clients. We do GWO training, Global Wind Organization. We've got trades such as the elevator industry who are working at height and they need to know what to do. Basic climbing stuff, but they also need to know what to do in case there's an emergency a couple hundred feet in the air. Your partner becomes incapacitated. What do you do? How do you get them back down to the ground? So we go through that type of stuff with the medical scenarios, how to put out fires, you name it.
If you're actually doing hands-on work in the industry, the best kind of training and education that somebody can give you as an employer is to send you to a course that forces you to do the same hands-on type things that you do during the workday.
Most of our courses here at Survival Systems start with some form of classroom. From the classroom, they'll take a break and they'll transition to the 28-foot climbing tower outside.
Basically, what we're trying to simulate is any kind of working at height emergency where if you have a partner or something like that, they get stuck on the ladder, they want to come down, but they maybe can't help themselves.
Today, we're working on if you get stuck, how you're going to get down safely. If you're working with someone else, how they can help you get down safely or how you're going to help them get down safely. Practice climbing up ladders, proper way, working hands-free.
All of them are gonna have harnesses on. On top of that, they all have what we call fall protection. So they have fall arrest and fall prevention. They use that fall arrest to basically mitigate any potential falling to the ground. And then they use fall prevention, which is actually the 3 points of contact. So that's gonna be their hands, their feet, as well as something that we call a work positioner. Work positioner is what I have right here.
It's tied off like this because in order to use this, I have to unhook one end, hook it onto something. See how it came right out easily? Hook it onto something, then I can, once this is hooked on, then I can move this onto my sternum.
That would connect to the ladder and make it so you have a zero fall distance. So that way, if you did let go, you can actually go hands-free and work without falling.
The courses have evolved and now we're showing you new equipment, new procedures. Yes, the concepts haven't changed, but the equipment and the way you apply them have changed.
After doing a week of training, I feel confident in how to climb, how to rescue someone.
You will have a good time here in training. It will not be boring. You'll learn a lot.
Our number one goal is coming home safe and to our families and just working safe every single day.